Hey, it's a cold day here in Grand Haven. We're here on the old Pier Marquette. What a beautiful machine. Just a couple of statistics on this whole thing. You take the locomotive, put it together with a coal car. I'm told this thing weighs something in the vicinity of some 400 tons. The thing has a capacity of 22,000 gallons of water, 22 tons of coal. And when this thing was cranking it out in its heyday, this could produce something in the vicinity of 3,000 horsepower. What a machine. It really is sweet being here in Grand Haven on this wonderful old locomotive on this cold, cold day. And one can't help but take a look at this thing and wonder what it must have been like in its heyday with the steam engine running down the tracks and pulling the cars behind it. It must have been a great, great experience. You know, today as we're talking about this matter of becoming a Christian and what it means to be sure and confident of your faith, I can't help but think that this matter of knowing Jesus and coming into relationship with Him, a growing relationship with Him, is an awful lot like marriage. It's like marriage in this way. It involves making a decision, making a choice, one that deals with your intellect, one that deals with your emotions, and one that deals with your will. I mean, when you think about it, most of the time when young couples get together and fall in love, they're attracted emotionally, they make that emotional connection, but if that goes very far and they start talking about marriage, pretty soon there's an awful lot of intellect that gets involved. It's intelligent decisions that have to be made about how they're going to support one another and how they're going to engage in this thing called marriage. But sooner or later, you go beyond the emotions, you go beyond the intellect, and you come to that great day when you say, I do. You exercise your will and you make a decision. Well, early in my Christian life, one of the things that someone shared with me that made so much sense was that in a very real way, my confidence of being a Christian was an awful lot like an old steam locomotive. You had the locomotive that represents fact, represents intellectual truth and choices. You've got the caboose, which is a good representation of your feelings. And then you've got the tender, the old coal car. And I remember the coal car really as something that represents your faith. And you and I, every day of our Christian lives, stand, as it were, on that coal car. We dig into the coal, get a shovel full of that coal, and then we're faced with decisions day after day. We can either toss our faith, toss our coal, if you will, into the caboose, in which case all you get is a dirty caboose, or you can toss it into the engine, into the facts, into the things that you know as being true. And when that happens, the old steam machine starts pumping and the engine starts going. And before you know it, you're moving down the track. Throw that coal into the caboose, see how far you go. You don't go very far. And that's an awful lot like believers who put their faith, who put their trust in their feelings, and then wonder why it is that they're hot and cold, why it is that they stop and go in their relationship with Christ. Learn to put your faith, learn to choose and make a decision and put your confidence in the facts, in the truth of the old locomotive. See if that won't cause you to grow down the tracks of spiritual growth in your own life.